So here first we write the algorithm for finding the square of a number. So just to convert this algorithm into our flowchart. So we study that the oval symbols are used for starting and stopping. So first we write the we draw the oval symbol and write start. So second one is we need to second here input a number and store it to a num. So we take it that input from the keyboard. So we use the parallelogram symbol for input. So input num. So the third step is here compute num into num and store it in the square variable. So we know that all the operations are we written inside that rectangle box. So square is equal to num into num. So that is written in that rectangle box. So so the next step is the print the square. So printing is also in the parallelogram. So input and output is in the parallelogram. So the last one is, so after printing we need to stop that algorithm, sorry stop that flowchart. We use stop for in the oval symbol. So this is the simple example for how to draw a flowchart. So first start using oval symbol, then input that number using parallelogram, then any operations like here the actual problem is find the square of a number. So we use square is equal to num into num, that is in the rectangle box. Then after the process we need to print that output. So print square, that is also in the parallelogram. Then after that we need to stop that flowchart. So this is a simple example for finding the square of a number. So next flowchart to find the largest among two number. So same that we start using oval symbol, then in order to find the largest among two number we need to read the two number from the keyboard. So input num1 and num2 using parallelogram. So third step is we need to check that either num1 or num2 is larger. So we check num1 is greater than num2. So it contains two options, yes and no. If the num1 is greater than num2, which means yes, we can print that num1 is larger. So it moves to the right side, yes part. So there is also one parallelogram is used for printing. So after printing it is moves to the stopping. So during the check, if the num1 is not greater than num2, then we can move to the no part. So which means that num2 is largest. So after printing num2 is largest, it is moved to the stopping condition. So this is the simple example. So the main important thing is after printing num1 is large or num2 is large, it is directly moved to the stopping statement. So a decision box contains a two path, either yes part or no part. So next, draw a flowchart to solve the problem of non-functioning light bulb. This is an example from your textbook. So the main problem is in order to find whether a bulb is correct or not, the functioning of a bulb is correct or not. So first we start, then check that the first there is a decision box. So inside that decision box we check that either switch is on or not. First we need to check the switch. So first we check that there is switch is on or not. If switch is not on, we move to the right part, which is no condition. Switch is on, that is a condition. So as if a switch is not on, we move to the right side, no part, then we going to switch on the switch. So that is a process, that is it is switch on in the rectangle box. So if again switch is on, then again we check that if bulb is on or not. If the bulb is on, then we can directly move to the stop condition. Then again check that if the bulb is not on, if the bulb is not on, then we can check that if the bulb is burned out. So there is again a check-in condition. If the bulb is burned out, then we can replace the bulb and move to the stop. If the bulb is not turned out, then we can call an electrician. So after calling electrician, it is also moves to the stop. So this is a simple example for how to draw a flowchart to solve the non-functioning light bulb. So this is simple example. So these are the way to solve algorithm to flowchart. So I already give a lot of algorithm. So try to convert all the algorithm to particular flowchart. If any doubt, ask me personally. Thank you.